Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. This is the next video in the virtual machine automation series with computer vision. Let us see the agenda for this video. We are going to start with a quick recap of the things which we have already covered, such as CV scope, how I can read the data, how we can extract the data, what is the new caching strategy, and the topic for this video would be the CV recorder. So let's get started. So the first thing, whenever we have to do any automation with the help of UiPath computer vision, I require something which is called a CV screen scope. All the activities which UiPath is going to perform on the virtual environment using the computer vision would come in this scope. To configure the CV scope, I require a URL and I require a API key. By default, it is set to cv.uipath.com, but in case you are new to this one, I have the first video in this series, the link is available in the description, where we are looking at how exactly can we configure the CV scope, right? So to start with anything on the CV recording, we would require something which is called the CV screen scope. Next, we have also seen in the previous video that there is something which is called a new caching strategy, which is something new in the CV scope, which simply means that if I have to automate 5 different screens on the virtual machine, I do not require 5 different CV scope. Everything is catered by a single CV scope only. This same thing you are also going to notice when we jump to something which is called the CV recorder, which is the topic for today. So in case you do not understand what is the caching strategy, I request you to watch the video whose link is available in the description so that you understand what exactly is the caching strategy. Next, to get the output from the computer vision, we have something which is called the get text output. As the name suggests, get the text output in the form of a string variable. In case I have something data which is in a tabular format, we have already seen that how we can extract the tabular data. So we have computer vision activities to get the tabular data as well. Meaning we have activities to provide input to the computer vision, as well as with the help of the computer vision activities, we can get the output as well as extract the tabular data as well. Okay, so that is all what we have already covered. In case you are new to UiPath and hearing the term recording for the first time, you can actually relate to this recording like recording a video from your mobile phone or your camera. Now, what is the benefit? Once you have recorded, you can actually go and replay the video any number of times, right? The same concept is applicable in UiPath as well, where you can actually record the automation and then you can rerun the automation again and again. Now, recording are of different types, such as basic, desktop, web, image, native Citrix, and computer vision. As you can see, this is the screenshot which I have taken from the community edition of UiPath. So if you are using the same, you would find this many kind of recordings. Basic and desktop are used to record the desktop application which are applicable and running in local. In case you want to know more about basic and the desktop recording, please have a look at the video which is available in the description, and that will help you to understand the basic and the desktop. This video, we are targeting something which is the last one, which is highlighted, which is called the computer vision recording, which means that how exactly can I use a computer vision recorder so that we can actually record the things which are available in a virtual desktop. Okay, let me go back to my machine. I have this virtual desktop available. As you can see, this is a remote desktop 161.202.27.59, right? It is open in a virtual machine, which means that if I go to the UiPath and if I try to use the basic and the desktop recording, let's say I try to simply use the basic recording, I click on the record and you would notice that it is not able to identify the elements inside the VDI. It is able to identify the elements in the local, right? But not inside the VDI, right? Hence, my basic desktop recorder would not work here. That is the place I need to go and use something which is called the last one, which is called computer vision, right? So I have this VDI. Let's decide a task. What do we want to do? So for example, I am on this website, which is called yahoo.com. So let's say I have a simple objective that I need to click on this finance button. Okay. As soon as I click on this finance button, you would notice that it is navigating to a new website, or it is navigating a new page where the layout is automatically getting updated, right? The new page is finance.yahoo.com. And let's say I simply want to search here, let's say Tesla. Okay. And I hit enter. Now, as soon as I hit Tesla, you would see that the layout again has changed. And for example, I want to write an automation where I want to extract this value out of this one, right? Now, if I have to use this with the help of single activities, we already know that I can use the click activity, we can use the CV scope, I can use the get text, caching strategy, everything, right? With the help of the recorder, all of the things would be done by the UiPath recorder for me. Let us see that in action. Okay. I go here in the recording and I will simply select the computer vision. It says that server key and API is missing or invalid. Copy it from the licenses page, right? So we have already seen that this thing we have already covered in the first video, that how you can actually get the computer vision key, right? To work with the computer vision, your UiPath assistant should be connected, right? So for me, it is connected and licensed. And you can also validate that which CV server are you connected to. You simply have to go to the project. Here you would see this button which says the project settings. It will open the project settings for you. You would find an option which is called the computer vision. And in here you could see that if you scroll down, so this is the runtime server which I am connected to, right? My UiPath studio is connected. I have the server details. So that means now we are good to go with the recording. Okay. Now let us try to do the recording. I go to the recording and from here I select something which is called the computer vision. I'll just pull up the VDI. All you have to do is just click on this button which says record. Now if you notice that your cursor has changed and it is asking us that which is the interface you want to automate, right? So I simply want to automate this screen. So you have to click on this screen. Now what would happen? It will analyze the screen and it will try to get the selector out of it. Now you would have noticed that if I move my mouse here, UiPath is uniquely able to identify the elements with the help of CV, right? This we have already seen. So all I have to do is click on this button which says finance, right? Once it has clicked on the finance button, now it has moved to a new page which is called finance.yahoo.com. If I was in a older version of the computer vision, I would have to re-indicate this screen. But since I am in the newer version, I do not need to do anything. Now let us see how exactly the caching strategy works and how I can automate this. So if I point my mouse to this search button, you would notice that I am not able to identify because the screen has changed. So all I have to do is go here and click on this button which says refresh, which means I am instructing the CV recorder that the layout has changed and you revalidate the elements, right? Now if I move my pointer, you could see that yes, I am able to select, right? Now from here, what I want to do, I simply want to type something. So if I simply click on this guy, right, it is asking me that what value you want to type. So I want to type, let's say Tesla, right? Do I want to clear the existing value? Yes. So I will tick on this one, which says empty field. Once this is typed, I want to hit an enter, right? So that you can directly do with using this plus button. And I just select enter. Once we are done, we just need to press enter once you are done. So I hit enter, right? So this is the action which the robot is going to take. And it will now navigate again to a new page. So again, it's a new page. So I do not need to again re-indicate. I just need to use something which is called refresh, right? Refreshing the screen. And now what we want to do, we want to get this value, let's say 877.51 something from out of the screen, right? So I can use simply this one, which says get the text. and let's point it to the value which we are interested in, right? We have got the text. Now, for example, there is a requirement where I want to extract a tabular format which is having rows and columns. We can always go and make use of the extract table, right? So as of now, let's try to save this recording and see what exactly we get, right? So I go here and I say save and exit. Okay. Now let me go back to my UiPath and it is asking me where do you want to save, right? So I want to save this in recording of CV and create. Now UiPath has created the sequence for me. And if you notice, everything is available in a single CV scope. And this is the caching strategy which I was talking about, that all the screens are available in the same CV scope, right? Now, if you see, first of all, it went to the screen number one. You always has an option to change all of this. We have already covered in the caching strategy video, right? So I hope you understand all of this now. This is anchor. So first of all, it is going to click on the finance, then going to type Tesla, then going to type text, right? So this was the recording. Now the thing about recording is that once you already have the recording, it is just a template for you. You always has an option to change the value, get the output and do the data manipulation. For example, instead of the Tesla, you want to search Microsoft. All you have to do is you can create a variable and pass the variable directly here, right? For example, CV get text is giving me a value in some output variable, right? As of now, it is blank. So I just go here and I hit Control plus K and I say str underscore output, right? So whatever value I am getting in this one, I have stored in this variable. Now, once the value is available in the variable, we can do a lot of things. So as of now, let's simply use a write line activity. And I will try to print the value in the console, right? So that means here what we are trying to do, we are trying to change the recorded version and we are trying to introduce our bits in it, right? We can always change this guy, data manipulation. You can run this automation as a different workflow. You can call this multiple number of times. We can have variables, we can have arguments, everything can be passed to this recording output. So what it has done, it has created a layout for me, right? Now that layout, that template, we can customize accordingly. Let me go back to the VDI and go back to the initial stage, which was the home page, right? Now, if I just go here and let's try to run this automation now, okay? I'll just pull up the VD. Go here and I say run the file. Okay, now in few moments the robot should start. Okay, we'll just wait. Yep, the robot has started. As you can see, the green indicates that the robot has started. Now the first thing, it was clicking on the finance.yahoo.com. It has opened finance.yahoo.com. The next thing is it has to go and it has to type the stock name which we have instructed. It has typed Tesla here. Now it is on the new page and it would have extracted the output, stored it, and it should have write line, right? If I go to the output here, you could see that 877.51 is typed on the console, which means that we were successfully able to retrieve the value out of the recorded output, right? So this is what I have printed here. Now you can always go and customize this option. You are free to explore all of bits, right? So if you notice here, the caching strategy is already taken care by UiPath. The refresh thing is already taken care by UiPath, right? So most of the bits are already taken care whenever we are doing the recording. In case we want to have the full control, we just can do the same automation by dragging and dropping the activities. Okay, so now let me go back to my presentation. And this is what we have seen, right? So recording is an important aspect of UiPath Studio. It saves us a lot of time when we are automating the processes. It enables us to capture the user actions and translates them into sequences of automation. Now, once it is created, we can actually modify, parameterize, replace them with variables, arguments, we can rerun them any number of times. These are all the recording options which are available, right? So now I hope you understand how exactly can I use the computer vision recording option. Let us quickly summarize. So we have seen that we have an option of CV recording, which saves us a lot of time whenever we are automating in VDI. It allows us to capture and it automatically creates the code for me. Once the code is created, we can easily modify and parameterize the code, right? So that was all about the CV recorder of UiPath. I would like to wrap this video here. I hope you found this video insightful and you are comfortable with the CV application now. If that is the case, please like this video, subscribe to the channel, and happy automation.